Designing a building usually does not end when the major building structures are done. The architect has to prove that the spaces are big enough to serve the functionalities. To simulate and visualize how a space can be used, we will place some handrails, furniture, fixtures, and site elements. These elements are stored under the Objects tool in ArchiCAD. You may continue working on the current project, or open the ACTS03 Chapter 5 PLN ArchiCAD Solo Project file to complete this chapter of the training series. The ArchiCAD library has a wider range of objects, including furniture, sanitary fixtures, special building structures, site elements, and so on. To open the set of available library parts, click the icon in the info box and review the Object Default Settings dialog. On the left side, you can see a folder structure by default. The self-explanatory folder names help you find the needed part by type. However, you can also use the search field where you can find library parts by their names and tags. On the right side, you can see the parameters of the currently selected library parts. Objects are GDL elements. Their settings are very similar to what you've already seen for doors and windows. If you open a new project, the standard ArchiCAD library is loaded. You can check and manage loaded libraries in the Library Manager dialog. You can open the dialog using File, Libraries and Objects, Library Manager. This dialog contains all information about the loaded libraries and elements and their status. For example, if it lists a missing object that does not exist in the default ArchiCAD library, then we have to load it. Objects created in the project are stored as embedded library parts automatically. For example, the StairMaker stair is now visible in the list. Click on the Add button and browse the Training Textures folder in the folder of this training file. Click Choose. Click the Reload Libraries and Apply All the Changes item. Click OK. Let's start by adding railings. The first objects we place are the missing railings on the gallery level terrace and stair opening. Open the 1-dot gallery floor plan from the navigator. Open the Object Settings dialog and type railing in the search field. Select Rail Wired in the list of found elements and set its settings as follows. Bottom Offset to Home Story to Current Story minus 0.15. Rotation Angle 90. Insertion Point bottom right. Home Story 1 Gallery. Rail Settings Pane. Dimension Section. Please adjust the settings as displayed on the screen. Handrail and Post Section. Handrail Width 0.10. Handrail Height 0.05. Layer Structural Combined. Click OK. Click the meeting point of the terrace slab and the exterior wall. Change the insertion point to bottom left and place another railing on the other open side of the terrace. Now, one railing is too short and the other is too long. Select one of them and click the mid-top hotspot. Select the Move Node command in the Pet palette to modify the horizontal length of the railing and drag it to the intersection point with the stone wall. Repeat this step and make the other railing as long as necessary. Go to the 3D view to check the results. The posts of the shorter railing are too dense. Let's remove one. Select the railing and open its settings. Set the number of posts to 2 in the rail settings, handrail and post section. Click OK. Now we'll create a railing for the stair opening inside. It takes quite a complex path, so instead of using library parts, we will create a profiled wall. Custom profiles allow us to create any kind of extruded geometry. You can also create profiled beams and columns. Profiled elements consist of a profile and an extrusion part. To define the profile, we have a special environment called Profile Manager. Open the Profile Manager by the options, Element Attributes, Profile Manager. By default, the project contains some predefined profiles. Click the New button to create the railing profile. Add a name, Gallery Railing, and click OK. A profile editor window opens. Here you can define the profile with fills, but you can use any lines as well as construction geometry. The small X icon indicates the baseline's position. We want to create a wood and glass railing. First, we draw the bottom wooden part. Activate the Fill tool. Open its Settings dialog and set this parameter. Fill pattern, timber, floor. Click OK. Select the rectangular geometry method and draw a rectangle starting at the X sign. Click the X and type X 0.05 and Y 0.3. Press Enter. Change the fill pattern to glass and draw another rectangle on top of the wooden one, 0.02 by 0.15. Draw the fill, then move it to the middle. Set the special snap options back to a long entire element if necessary. Create another wooden fill, 0.05 by 0.15. Select the top two fills and drag a copy upwards so the railing is 0.90 meters high. In the Design Layers panel, check the horizontal and vertical stretch checkboxes. Additional lines appear. These lines control what happens if you resize the wall height. If these are on, the part between the lines will be stretched. If turned off, the stretch height command is not available. Drag the horizontal lines to the middle of the glass part's fills. This way, if you stretch the wall, the footing and the handrail parts will maintain their size. Click the Store Profile button. Close the Profile Manager. Navigate to the gallery interior so you can see the opening. Activate the Wall tool. Open its Settings dialog and adjust the settings as follows. Reference Line, Outside Face, Reference Line Offset, 0.0. Structure, Complex, Wall Top, Not Linked, Complex Structure Profile, Gallery Railing. Tags, non-load-bearing element, interior, railing. Click OK. Select the chained geometry method and click the corners of the opening. Adding the railing to the other edge of the slab in 3D is very cumbersome because there's not enough room to see both endpoints. Let's hide part of the model. You can use the Marquee tool for this purpose. The light marquee only affects the current story. The bold marquee affects all stories. Open the One Gallery floor plan from the Navigator. Activate the Marquee tool in the toolbox and select the All Floors or Bold method in the info box. Draw a rectangle around the upper half of the building. Right-click and select Show Selection Marquee in 3D. The 3D window opens with the selected part of the model. Please don't forget to activate the Wall tool first. Now you can easily draw the railing wall starting from the right side. To show the full model content again, right-click and select Show All in 3D. Open the Layer Settings dialog and turn on the visibility of the site and landscape terrain layer in case the terrain elements are hidden in 3D.